Happy Thanksgiving to those of you residing in the United States of America, and happy late Thanksgiving to those of you in Canada, because that was a while ago. I need to move because there's a dishwasher on behind me. Sorry this is so late. I was in the hospital. I just got out yesterday at like 1 p.m. And since then I've been doing preparation for Thanksgiving with my family, so I have not had a chance to make my video until now. I had to take a nap from my holiday haze. And I really don't think it's due to turkey because I'm a vegetarian. First question is, what is your opinion of Transgender Day of Remembrance? I have mixed feelings about the Transgender Day of Remembrance. I think, first of all, it's a great starting place. However, I don't really know what its status is as a holiday or whatever in international scopes. I'm sure that there's some way to change it in the future. I just hope that it's not stuck as a day of remembrance forever, because I think that we do need a way to celebrate our community and not just a day that is really labeled as to remember our dead. I know that many of us do more than just remember our dead on Transgender Day of Remembrance, although unfortunately at this stage in our community's history, that is still a large part of what we do. Luckily, there's a cat tail. Because of a lot of progressive reform in the last few years. Celebration has become more prominent. I guess that kind of tells you that I don't like the implications of the fact that we only get a day to remember our dead, and I guess, you know, we sort of get part of coming out day, though that is seen as a traditionally gay and lesbian and sometimes bisexual day. Hi, Josh. I won't go into the politics of how I feel about sexual people getting shafted, because that's another topic entirely. But yeah, Josh is here. He came to my Thanksgiving. I lost my train of thought. I can't remember what I was thinking. I think I was talking about the gay community has so much, and I guess that, you know, we traditionally include, like, the whole LGBT community in it, but it's really the LG for sure, and the B, and perhaps some other undescribed people in there that get those activities, like Coming Out Day and Pride Month. Traditionally seen as gay holidays and don't bring that much awareness to trans issues. Even though transgender people often celebrate during those times, it doesn't really bring to the public any sort of anything. It doesn't really tell the public anything about trans issues. It really only gets talked about within the gay community during those events. So, that's unfortunate. So, I think that Transgender Day of Remembrance needs to be escalated a little bit, given a little bit of oomph, and renamed at some point, hopefully in the near future, and we can start doing a little something else besides remembering our dead. I think our community deserves a lot of celebration because we have a lot of strong people in our community that go through a lot to get where they're going, and we need to celebrate the strengths of the people and our community in general. What?
I think there needs to be a day of us celebrating the way we are, and I don't think that there's necessarily more strong
I wasn't trying to imply that there's more strong trans people. I'm just saying that there's not a day to celebrate strong trans people. There's already an entire month that brings visibility to the strong gay people. And I'm saying visibility here because, like I said, the whole LGBT group of people usually celebrates during Pride Month, and but the visibility usually goes to people that identify as gay and lesbian and bisexual. So that's my opinion of that. It needs to be more. We need to do more celebrating, and we need to have some crazy flag. I don't think I want to get into the nudity. I don't think most of us would be comfortable with that. Seeing as our day is in November, it probably would be rather hard to pull off anyway, unless you're hemisphere. So I don't think that will be part of Transgender Day of whatever it hopefully be renamed in the future. So what do you do, or I what do I do to celebrate or remember the trans community? I personally don't plan, I didn't plan anything during Transgender Day of Remembrance other than attending the things that are already available on my campus, because there's a lot of stuff compared to just the one day. We made it into a whole week because Transgender Remembrance Day was just part of Transgender Awareness Week, which is really what I think Transgender Remembrance Day should be more of. So we did a teaming up of our LGBT discussion group with our trans group, and we talked about trans people in the public. And Tuesday we had we just like continued the events. We had a panel on what's being done in trans health, and Wednesday we had a luncheon and discussed, you know, awareness in our community. And Thursday was the actual vigil that we held, where we, instead of this year just reading names, which we did on Friday, we actually talked about the lives of transgender people, which I thought was more constructive because you got to see what happened to these people and the kind of lives they lived and the quality of person they were, instead of just a name read off at a vigil. And unless you read the news story when it happened, you would have no idea who the heck they were. But, you know, besides during transgender remembrance time, I celebrate the trans community by participating in it in general instead of just pretending that I don't exist as a trans person. Transstar Galactica is a great way to do that. For instance, my own YouTube channel, which I'm going to be updating here shortly, is another way that I do that. When I have time, I participate in trans forums, and I participate in trans groups, and I try to bring trans awareness into pretty much everything that I do, barring a few activities that would just be out of place. But if it gets brought up, hey, it's fair game. And you know, I don't know if it's so much as celebrating as bringing awareness, but yeah, I don't really know that I remember the trans community a lot, other than, you know, when I encounter situations that are troublesome for me, I think about how it would be for other people. And I do try to pause when I learn about a tragedy, but Transgender Day of Remembrance, unfortunately, is the time when I remember people most, but I prefer to celebrate and strive for those of us still living on the behalf of those that have gone before us, because if we don't keep doing that, then we won't get anywhere. And I feel like their lives would be lost in vain. So, yeah. So I feel like it's a celebration of the trans community just to not be afraid to go sit in a public place with a bunch of my trans friends and talk freely about trans politics and anything and everything to do with trans people. I think that is wonderful. I think that's a celebration of the trans community right there, to not be afraid to go out in public and talk about that when people normally don't perceive me as anything other than a slightly shorter than normal cisgendered male. So that works for me. I mean, I think that's an awesome celebration of the trans community, that we have come that far, that we can just go sit out in public and have a chat and Sparky's ice cream and eat weird flavored ice cream while my friends come in and out and don't think it's odd that I'm sitting there having a conversation with people that they may or may not know are trans. I think that's a celebration of the trans community. I think the simple things that we do in everyday life is a celebration of the trans community. And I think that's all that I have to say.